So hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to Creatrix channel. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Vishal Soni and I have cleared engineering services examination 2 times from electronics and telecommunication branch, both times in double digit rank. In 2014, my rank was 98 and in 2015, my rank was 25th. I have served as a Group A Gazetted Officer in Indian Railways and in Indian Telecommunication Services. So most of you must have been following me on the Creatrix channel for electromagnetic field theory. So if you are a seeker of a free education, this is the channel for you. And you must understand that all these free initiatives is coming your way because of the Unacademy. So Unacademy is the revolution in the field of the free education and the affordable education. So how can you access those free courses? So if you want to access the free courses, you must immediately subscribe this channel, Creatrix channel, because all the top educators of the country is providing the free course on this channel. And that free course is absolutely brilliant in content, that is systematic, that is organized, and that is complete. So complete playlist you will be getting of a particular subject. You can develop the concept, you can gain confidence, more than that, you can love the subject. So immediately subscribe this channel. Secondly, if you want to access more free content, then you must immediately download the Unacademy Learners app, because on the Unacademy Learners app, top educators of the country are conducting the free special classes. In that free special classes, you can get topic wise clarity of a particular concept. And do not forget to follow me on the Unacademy learning app. So you can also access the courses. So you must have 2 things. First is your YouTube channel. This YouTube channel, Creatrix YouTube channel, must be subscribed. Secondly, you must understand that you should have the Unacademy learning app. That is must for you in order to crack the examination. So these are the parts of the free education. And if you want to organize your content well, if you want more comprehensive manner, if you want other advantages of the Unacademy, then what are the other initiatives that is running by the Unacademy? So another initiative that is running by the Unacademy is Unacademy Plus. So on the Unacademy Plus, this is very affordable for those who actually want to take their preparation to the next level. So aapko Unacademy Plus mein kya kya milega? You will be getting the live classes on a fixed time so that you can get more disciplined, you can get more organized, and you have something in your mind that at this particular time my classes are going to run. Apart from that, you will get free test series designed by the educator itself. So gone those times when we have lot of errors in the test series, we do not have the discussions of the test series. So there the test series will be conducted by the educators. They themselves will be discussing the solutions of that particular thing. So you can imagine that your preparation is going to the next level for this. Apart from that, those who have prepared themselves for the examination, so for them there are crash courses also available. Again, the crash courses will going to help you in achieve good ranks. Those who have already achieved good ranks and want to improve their rank, for them there are rank improvement batches. More than that, you can also see that there are unlimited practice sessions. So what do you understand by unlimited practice session? Which means there will be various doubt solving sessions. Apart from the doubt solving sessions, there are weekly quizzes, and with the help of those weekly quizzes, you can enhance your problem solving skills. So lot of unlimited doubt solving sessions, lot of quiz sessions, systematic content, structured content. You can download the PDF after the lectures, so you don't have to waste your time in order to making notes. You can utilize those times to practice the particular concepts, or you can use those times to just write down the formulas so that you can remember those formulas quickly. Apart from this plus subscription, there is also one subscription which is known as Iconic. So Iconic subscriptions are for them who actually do not have the self motivation but having the talent. So if they are having the talent and you do not have the self motivation that how can I push myself to crack the examination, so in this Iconic subscription you will be assigned a personal coach. So this personal coach is going to be with you every time, and he will help you to achieve your dreams. You will get a study planner which will be customized for you. You will get the expert guidelines who have already topped the examination. They will be basically hand holding you to crack the examination. So if you think you are not self motivated, if you think you do not have the proper background to crack any particular competitive examination, so this Iconic subscription is must for you. This is going to help you. So if you want the free education, then YouTube channel and the special classes are must for you. And if you can afford a little bit, how much you should afford, that we'll discuss in a while. But if you can afford a little bit, you should come onto this Unacademy Plus. And more than that, if you want the expedited process in your preparation, aap jaldi se exam nikalna chahte hain, jaldi se apni galtiyan sudharna chahte hain, so this Iconic subscription is for you. Then now let us start today's lecture, which is on the communication system. So now let us start the lecture. Hello friends. So in the last lecture we studied about the peak detector circuit. Now in this lecture, let us understand how a low pass filter behaves as a smoothing filter.
So before that, we have to recall few concepts of the Fourier series and Fourier transform. We know that if x of t is periodic signal with fundamental period t naught, then we can calculate the exponential Fourier series coefficient of x of t as cm. Now, if we have to calculate the Fourier transform of x of t, which will be x omega, so this Fourier transform will be 2 pi summation of del of omega minus n omega naught into cn, or x of f can be written as del of f minus nf naught into cn, where n varies from minus infinite to infinite. So the Fourier transform of a periodic signal can be written as x of f, which is equal to summation of n equal to minus infinite to infinite cn del of f minus nf naught, and this f naught is nothing but fundamental time period 1 by t naught. So the Fourier transform of a periodic signal depends upon the Fourier series coefficient of that particular signal. Now let me consider a signal. I am considering x of t to be a symmetrical square wave. So this is x of t. It is periodic in nature. X of t versus t. So this will be 0. This point is t naught by 2, and this is t naught. This is its one time period t naught. Now we know that this particular signal x of t is real and even, which means the Fourier series coefficient cn will also be real and even. Also, this signal x of t is half wave symmetric. So whenever signal is half wave symmetric, the Fourier series coefficient cn becomes 0 for n even, and c naught also becomes 0. Or we can say that this particular signal x of t will contain only odd harmonics. So now let me write its Fourier transform. So the x of t will have Fourier transform of x of f. Now this x of t has Fourier series coefficient as cn, which is 0 for n even, and c naught is also 0. We know that Fourier transform x of f will be summation of cn del of f minus nf naught, and n varies from minus infinite to plus infinite. But since cn is 0 for n even and c naught is also 0, so what we can write, we can replace this formula with c of k del of f minus kf naught, where k assumes only odd values and k can never be 0. So if I will expand, this is symmetrical square wave x of t, and if I will expand x of f, so x of f will contain c minus 3 del of f plus 3 f naught, c minus 1 del of f plus f naught, c1 del of f minus f naught, c3 del of f minus 3 f naught, and so on. So this will be the spectrum of x of f. So if I have to draw the spectrum of x of f, so this is the signal x of t, which is a symmetrical square wave, and its Fourier transform will be x of f versus f. So the Fourier transform will have frequency component at f naught and minus f naught. So this is c1, this will be c minus 1. Another component at 3f naught, so it will be c3 and minus 3f naught. Another component at 5f naught, that is c5. Here also minus 5f naught and c minus 5. So this particular signal x of p will have infinite number of frequencies, which is present at f naught, 3f naught, 5f naught. All are integer multiples of f naught, also odd integer multiples of fundamental frequency f naught, and this is the time period t naught. Now what you can observe from here, that this particular time domain signal contains infinite number of frequencies, that to all the odd harmonics which is present in the signal. Now from here you can also see that since x of t is real and even, so Cn has to be real and even by using symmetry properties. So value of C minus n will always be equal to Cn. That is why I am assuming C1 is equal to C minus 1, C3 is equal to C minus 3, and so on. So we have obtained the frequency domain spectrum of x of t. Now what we can do is, if I am passing this signal x of t through a low pass filter, and this low pass filter has frequency spectrum from 1.5 f naught to 1.5 f naught, and let us assume the pass band gain is 1, and we have to obtain this output yt. So we know that to obtain the output yt, yt will be x of t convolved with h of t, or I can write as y of f equal to x of f into h of f. X of f we have already obtained, so this was x of f. Frequency is present at f naught, 3f naught, 5f naught, and so on. This was f naught, 3f naught, 5f naught, minus f naught, minus 3f naught, minus 5f naught. The spectrum of the low pass filter is given from 1.5 f naught to 1.5 f naught, and this amplitude is 1. So the spectrum of yf comes out to be f naught minus f naught, c minus 1, c1. Very clearly you can see from here that if the low pass filter has cutoff frequencies less than 1.5 f naught, and from here also minus 1.5 f naught, then this much of spectrum will be allowed by the low pass filter, and all these spectrums will be suppressed by the low pass filter. So the spectrum of yf comes out to be this is the spectrum of yf. One impulse is present at f naught, another impulse is present at minus f naught. This is c1, this is also c1. So I can write yf as c1 del of f plus f naught plus c1 del of f minus f naught. We know that c1 is equal to c minus 1. So yf becomes c1 del of f plus f naught plus del of f minus f naught. We know that the Fourier transform of cos 2 pi f naught t is 1 by 2 del of f minus f naught plus 1 by 2 del of f plus f naught. So you can write it as 2c1 cos 2 pi f naught t will have spectrum as c1 del of f minus f naught plus c1 del of f plus f naught. If this is your yf, then it is going to be yt. So we know that x of t was symmetrical square wave. Now I passed this symmetrical square wave through a low pass filter, and the output that I got was nothing but a sinusoidal signal. So what happened actually? Let us try to understand. This was the signal x of t, and it was symmetrical square wave. So this was the signal x of t. This was given input to the low pass filter. Now, if I have to make y of t, then y of t is nothing but cosine signal. So the graph of cosine signal will look something like this. This is the graph of cosine signal, or this is your y of t output of low pass filter. So what this low pass filter does, you can see if I will observe this x of t waveform. So you can see that it is making a very sharp change to reach from this point to this point. So this change is sharp, while output is making very smooth change to reach between these two points. Similarly, here also you can see it is making very sharp change to reach from this point to this point, while output of the low pass filter is very smoothly reaching between these two points. From between these two points, you can also see the input is making very sharp changes, while output is smoothly tracking all those points. So you can say that the sharp changes in x of t has been smoothened by the low pass filter. So whenever any waveform which has very sharp changes has been passed through a low pass filter, then what low pass filter does, it makes these sharp changes very smooth between two points. So we will arbitrarily choose any two points, and the curve can be made smoother between these two points. In this way, a low pass filter behaves as smoothing filter. So this is the purpose of the low pass filter. Now let us try to understand what is an envelope detector. So till now we have understood about the peak detector circuit. Let us try to understand the envelope detector. So we have already discussed that envelope detector is nothing but combination of a peak detector circuit followed by a low pass filter. So whenever we will give x of t here, the output will be tracking of the envelope of x of t, and when we will smooth those trackings, we will get z of t, and this z of t should provide us the envelope e of t. So this is the general diagram of envelope detector. At this peak detector circuit, we know that the charging time constant should be zero and the discharging time constant should be sufficiently large. If these two phenomena happens, then Y of T will detect all the peaks. Also, it will give tracking of envelope of X of T. Now, when this tracking of envelope of X of T is given to the low pass filter, this low pass filter smoothes the curve between two peaks. And finally, we get the envelope. So this is the basic working of an envelope detector. Let us try to understand from the same example which we are taking every time. So this is the signal X of T, which is A sine omega naught T. This is the signal. And if I will connect all these peaks, we will get the envelope A. X of T is A sine omega naught T. So what is the envelope of this signal? We know that if we will trace all the positive peaks, then we will get the envelope. So this is the envelope of this particular signal. Now, what happens if I will pass X of T through peak detector circuit? In this peak detector circuit, RSC is tending to zero, RLC is sufficiently large, and we need to make the diagram of YT. So let me make the diagram of YT. This is your X of T equal to A sine omega naught T versus T. And I have to plot Y of T. So we know that first of all, capacitor will charge to its peak value. This is A. Then it will discharge. Then again it will charge to the peak value. It will discharge and so on. So the graph of YT can be redrawn like this. This is the peak value A. This is your YT. And the graph will be something like this. This is the peak, then discharging, then again obtains the peak, discharging, again obtains the peak, discharging, and so on. So this YT tracks ET. Now, from this diagram, you can very clearly see that this envelope is a DC signal. So since envelope is a DC signal, so in DC signals, no ripples can be present. So here, no ripples are present. But what about YT? If you will observe YT, then you can observe in YT, it is not a DC signal. Rather, it is a tracking of this DC signal E of T. Also, when it is not a DC signal and it is having some variations, which means in the time domain, the value is decreasing in this region, then increasing, decreasing, increasing. So also ripples are present or some AC nature is also present in this signal. Now what I want to do, I want to pass this Y of T through a low pass filter. We know that whenever any input is passed to a low pass filter will try to smooth that curve. So what it will do, it will observe the peaks. This is the first peak, this is the second peak, third peak, and so on. And this abrupt graph should be smoothened by the low pass filter. So low pass filter will try to smooth this waveform. And the output of low pass filter will be and the graph is little bit smoother, and again smooth graph. So you can see that now this y naught t or z t gives better tracking of et than yt. So obviously when the curve has been smoothened, it will give a better tracking of this a rather than the yt. Also ripple content is reduced. So whenever it is passed through the low pass filter, the approximation or the tracking of envelope becomes better and ripple content is reduced. What happens ideally? Ideally, low pass filter observes peaks of YT and smoothes the curve in between. So in the last case which we discussed was a practical case, but ideally what we can assume is if we have obtained the YT waveform which is the tracking of this A, charge, this is peak, discharge, then again this peak, discharge, then again this peak, and so on. So ideally what happens, this low pass filter will observe these peaks. So it has to reach from this peak to this peak, and this is your sudden changes. So what it will do is will simply smooth the curve between these two peaks. Similarly, low pass filter has to reach from this point to this point, and this is the sudden path. So what it will do, it will smooth this particular path and so on. So ideally what you will get z of t as this is your A, and ideally you will get DC signal after some transient, and that transient I'm denoting it as t naught dash. So this is your DC value, or this is your exact envelope. So in ideal case we follow this method that it will always smooth the curve between two peaks following the envelope, but practically ripples cannot be removed and there might be some ripples present. So all the ripples cannot be removed practically. There should be some ripples present, or there will always be some ripples present, but ideally we can consider that we can always get the exact envelope as envelope was given in the particular signal. Or if the envelope of a signal is desired to be detected, then we can always detect the exact envelope ideally. But practically the envelope obtained by this process will be somewhat different from the exact envelope, or some ripples will always be present. Hello friends, so in the last lecture we discussed about the complete operation of an envelope detector. That envelope detector is nothing but a circuit in which first block is peak detector, another block is low pass filter, and low pass filter acts as smoothing filter. Now let us understand how an envelope detector can act as an AM demodulator. So first of all let me draw the diagram we know that the AM signal will be some AC plus MT cos omega CT, or I can write it as A of T cos omega CT. So first of all, the signal whose envelope is to be detected will be applied here. In this case, it is the AM signal. This is the resistance RS. After that, I will apply a PN junction, which is a diode. Now, this diode is connected with this capacitor C and a load resistance RL. So, we have denoted the output of this RL as YT. So, this output becomes YT. Now, output of this peak detector circuit will be passed through a low pass filter, and output of the low pass filter we visually denote with Z of T. After that, we will use another circuit, which is DC blocker, and output of this DC blocker Z naught T we want to calculate. So from starting to this point, this circuit is a peak detector circuit. Now we know that this low pass filter is nothing but smoothing filter. It smooths the curve between two positive peaks, and further onwards this circuit is a DC blocker circuit. So first of all, what will be the YT? The YT will give the tracking of AT, which is AC plus MT. So YT gives the tracking of the envelope, which is in this case AC plus MT. Now what will be the Z of T? Now Z of T will smooth this tracking, or it will reduce the tracking error. So Z of T will approximately will be equal to AC plus MT. And now if it is passed through a DC blocker circuit, we will obtain our message signal. So this is the basic working of envelope detector as a AM demodulator. Now let us understand how graphically we will obtain M of T back. So this is our M of T. I am considering this M of T to be sinusoidal. So this is the sinusoidal M of T. Now because of this sinusoidal M of T, I can consider this time period to be, this is AM sine 2 pi FMT. So I can consider this time period T naught to be 1 by FM. This value is 0. This is AM and this is minus AM. Now, if mu is less than 1, in that case, AM by AC will also be less than 1, or you can write AC minus AM will be greater than 0. So, if I will draw the diagram of AC plus MT, so the diagram of AC plus MT should look something like this. This is the diagram of AC plus MT. The whole graph will shift in the up direction. So I'm making this axis with AC, and the graph will look like something this. This is the graph of AC plus MT. This value becomes AC plus AM, and this value becomes AC minus AM. And obviously the distance between these two peaks remains 1 by FM. So we know that the amplitude modulated signal is AC plus MT cos omega CT. So if I have to draw the amplitude modulated signal in time domain, so first of all I will draw this A of T in dotted format. So this is A of T. Now we will take its mirror image. So this is the graph of AC plus MT, and in between we have to draw this cos omega CT. So I'll be drawing the cos omega CT in between. So this is the graph of cos omega CT. And this is your amplitude modulated signal. So from here, if you'll observe that this duration between these two peaks will be 1 by FC, because in between we are drawing the cos omega CT, which is having the frequency of omega C, but it is following the shape of this particular envelope AC plus MT. So this is our modulated signal. Now, I want to apply this modulated signal to the peak detector. So first of all, I would like to give this signal to a peak detector circuit, and I would like to obtain the output YT. So for that, I am assuming that this charging time constant is tending to zero, which means YT will detect all the peaks, and this RLC to be sufficiently large so that YT tracks the envelope of SAMT once the peak is detected. So these two assumptions I am taking. If peak has not been detected, then even if RLC is sufficiently large, it will not be able to track properly the envelope of SAMT. So for proper tracking of envelope, two conditions must be met. RSC must be zero so that peaks can be detected, because envelope is nothing but the trace of the positive peaks. So even if the peaks are not detected, then the trace cannot be drawn properly. So for proper tracking of envelope, at least the peaks of the given diagram must be detected. So for proper tracking of envelope, the charging time constant should be very low so that peaks can be detected, and if peaks can be detected, then by tracing those peaks we can draw the envelope. So the detection of peak is first and most important part. After that, this RLC should be sufficiently large so that After the detection of the peak, the envelope of SAMT can also be tracked properly. So, for proper tracking of envelope, first of all, peaks must be detected. Once the peaks are proper, then this RLC, which is sufficiently large, will ensure that the complete envelope has been tracked properly. So, now let us try to track the envelope. So, I am taking these two conditions, and based upon these two conditions, I would like to draw the diagram of YT. So, first of all, I will draw the diagram of SAMT. So, this is the envelope . This is your AC plus MT or the envelope. So I will also take its mirror image. Now in between I will draw the cosinusoidal signal. So the cosinusoidal signal will be this. So this is our AM signal. Now I am applying this AM signal to a peak detector circuit and I have to draw the output YT. So what this peak detector will do? We know that if I have already ensured that RSC is very small and RLC is sufficiently large, then YT will first of all track all the peaks. After that it will discharge. So if I will start from here, then it will first of all charge to the peak. After that it will discharge and it will intersect this input signal here. After intersecting, it will again charge to its peak value. Now it will again discharge and it will intersect at this point. Then again it will charge to the peak value. It will again discharge. Will again discharge here, intersection. After intersection, charging will occur up to the peak value. After the charging up to peak value, it will again discharge. Intersection with input signal occurs here. After the intersection, it will again charge to the peak value. After charging to the peak value, this discharging will occur again. The intersection with input signal occurs here, then it will again charge to the peak value, and this cycles repeats on and on. So we have obtained this graph of Y of T. So let me draw this Y of T separately. So before that, let me summarize the operation. So YT charges to peak value of SAMT. After that, YT discharges and intersects SAMT at some T, and charges again to peak value, and these two processes repeats, that YT charges to the peak value, then it discharges and intersects SAMT at some point, and then again it charges to the peak value. So these two points repeat on and on. So let me draw this Y of T separately. So this is Y of T and this is the envelope. This is your envelope AC plus MT, and this was YT. So this is the envelope YT. So from here you can see that YT is giving very good approximation of this envelope E of T. This is E of T signal and this is Y of T. And this Y of T is giving very good approximation of EET with very small tracking errors. So here this YT is tracking envelope of SAMT, which is AC plus MT. So what will happen if I will pass it through a low pass filter? So now if I will pass this Y of T through a low pass filter, then we have obtained this Y of T something like this. This is our Y of T, charging to the peak value, discharging, charging to the peak value, and so on. So this is Y of T. We have already understood that what a low pass filter will do, it will detect the peaks of the YT. So these are the peaks of the YT, and it will try to smoothen the curve between these two peaks. So let me try to smooth this curves. So ideally it will connect these two peaks smoothly, which means between these two peaks we are following this sudden path. So it will smooth this particular path something like this. Similarly, between these two peaks we are following this path, which is abrupt path, and low pass filter will smooth this peaks. So while it will connect all the positive peaks and smooth this particular curve, and you can see here when the curve has been smooth or YT has been passed through low pass filter, so the output Z of T is approximately equal to the AC plus MT, which is the envelope of the given signal. So the graph of Z of T that we have obtained is approximately AC plus MT. So this is your AC plus MT, which is Z of. Now, if I will pass it through a capacitor, which is a DC blocker circuit, then the output will become a sinusoidal signal, which is again M of T. So very clearly, we are able to detect our message signal from the modulated signal. So this envelope detector behaves as a AMD modulator, and this envelope detector has three important components. First one is peak detector circuit, second one is low pass filter which acts as smoothing filter, and third one is DC blocker or a capacitor.
So if you have liked today's lecture and you want to subscribe to an Academy Plus, the very first thing that you should understand that you should use this particular code. What is the code? The code is Vishal Gate. Write my name and attach gate to it. So by using this particular code, you will be getting all the advantages of the Unacademy Plus. All the added advantages will be directly assigned to you. Secondly, you will directly come to under my guidance, and that will surely help you to crack the examination in the least possible time. And you will also get the guidance of the complete team. Okay. And the most important thing is that you will immediately get the 10% discount on that. So immediately you are enabled to get 10% discount once you use this coupon code. So for example, if you talk about the plus subscription, which is costing you 25,000 for 1 year, and if you use this coupon code Vishalgate, immediately you are going to get 10% discount, which is 22,500. And if you talk about the Iconic, for the Iconic subscription of the 12 month, this will cost you around 40,400. So these are the cost of the 12 months. And if you want to talk about the 2 year subscription, 2 year subscription cost of the plus, it is your 27,000 after discount. If you want more discount than 10%, and you have already attended the special classes, then you will be having some credits in your account. Do not forget to use those credits so that you can get more discount than 10%. Now, how can you pay these amounts? So there is one good news for you, that you can pay this amount by using credit cards and debit cards, by using the facility of the zero cost EMI. So if you want to pay this particular amount of 22,500 with the help of zero cost EMI, so the zero cost EMI can be availed by using credit cards and debit cards. Remember, you can use the credit card of any company, but the debit card is allowed for HDFC and the Bajaj Finserv. Apart from that, if you want to directly pay this much of amount, you think that this particular amount is the most affordable fees that can be provided to you for 1 year subscription, so aap directly kya kar sakte hain, you can use this credit card, debit card direct payment. You can also go for the EMI options, okay, and you can directly pay this amount by using net banking. Every time you think of the Unacademy Plus subscription, the first thing that should come in your mind is this particular code. Do not forget to use this code once you take the subscription, because I have already told you that this particular coupon code is going to give you a lot of advantages, so you cannot miss the opportunity to use this code. So every student who want to come on to the Unacademy Plus, they want to take the advantages of the Unacademy Plus, they want to empower themselves in the best possible manner in this digital era, they want to be the part of this revolution, then this is the time for you. You do not have to wait for it. If you are in the first year, if you are in the second year, you are in the third year, the best possible time is right now to prepare for the examination, to dedicate yourself, to give yourself the opportunity so that you can get the success as early as possible. Apart from that, you should also join this GATE aspirant group. So this GATE aspirants group is already having 150k plus students, so you can join it. There are a lot of discussions going on between students. You can get the advantage of those discussions. Okay, you can also join this Creatrix channel, which is a Telegram channel. So everyone has to join this channel so that you can get all the PDFs of the lecture which is being assigned to you. Fine, there are various channels which you can go for it. So various channels in the association with Creatrix, so you can follow the channel of your interest. And this is it in today's lecture. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you so much.